All right, guys, now I want to talk about the relationship between the equilibrium constant and the pKa. All right, so remember that in general chemistry, we were always talking about something called pH, okay? And pH was used to measure what? Do you guys remember? It was actually used to measure the concentration of hydronium ions in a solution. In solution. Okay? So I know that's really specific, but it was used to basically measure how acidic a solution was. How acidic or how basic. Okay? But it turns out that in organic chemistry, we don't care about the solution at all. We don't care if it's acidic or if it's basic at all. What we care about is the actual molecule itself. And what I care about is how likely is that molecule to donate a proton, or how likely is that molecule to accept a proton. pH doesn't tell me that. pH just tells me how many H pluses are circulating in this test tube. I don't care about that. I care about the molecules inside. I care how much are they likely to give away a proton. Okay? So that means that we're going to use a different measure. We're going to use the negative log of the equilibrium constant, or the dissociation constant. Remember that dissociation constant has to do with how likely a bond is to break. Okay? So we're going to use the negative log of how likely that is to happen to figure out for the tendency of a molecule to donate protons. Okay? And that's what we actually care about. So that's why in gen chem you use pH, but now in orgo we're going to use pKa instead. Okay?